وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Quran Circle 3. Quran Circle means that we get together to recite the Quran and to listen to the Quran, so that we can reflect upon its meanings, so that we can act according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the purpose of our life. This is our duty on the face of earth. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us and to bless us and to give us the reward of recitation and listening and reflecting and acting according to the Quran. Inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, we'll recite Surah Al-Anbiya. Surah Al-Anbiya. It's a very beautiful surah that has many, many names of the prophets of Allah. The most surah that includes names of the prophets of Allah. So many things to be learned and many beautiful verses for us to listen to with our reciters. We would like to introduce them first. We have Sheikh Ahmad Rajab. Welcome to the program.
Welcome. Thank you.
And we have also with us Sheikh Abdulrahman Saeed. Welcome, Sheikh Abdulrahman.
Welcome. Thank you.
And we have also with us Sheikh Kareem Saudi.
Thank you.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your coming and for you to recite to us. And please, again, if you have a Mus'haf, a Quran with you, open it and follow with the recitation so that we can all benefit, inshallah ta'ala, the listening to the Quran and also learning how to recite. So more rewards, the more actions we do, the more rewards we get, inshallah ta'ala. We'll talk about the surah, inshallah ta'ala, but let's start first with the beginning of Surah Al-Anbiya. And the recitation of Sheikh Ahmad Rajab. So please go ahead, inshallah, and start.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. ما يأتيهم من ذكر من ربهم محدث إلا استمعوه وهم يلعبون. لاهية قلوبهم وأسروا النجوى الذين ظلموا هل هذا إلا بشر مثلكم أفتأتون السحر وأنتم تبصرون. قال ربي يعلم القول في السماء والأرض وهو السميع العليم. بل قالوا أضغاث أحلام بل افتراه بل هو شاعر فليأتنا بآية كما أرسل الأولون. ما آمنت قبلهم من قرية أهلكناها أفهم يؤمنون. وما أرسلنا قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم. فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. وما جعلناهم جسدا لا يأكلون الطعام الطعام وما كانوا خالدين ثم صدقناهم الوعد فأنجيناهم ومن نشاء وأهلكنا المسرفين لقد أنزلنا إليكم كتابا فيه ذكركم أفلا تعقلون وكم قصمنا من قرية كانت ظالمة وأنشأنا بعدها قوما آخرين فلما أحسوا بأسنا إذا هم منها يركضون لا تركضوا وارجعوا إلى ما أترفتم فيه ومساكنكم لعلكم تسألون قالوا يا ويلنا إنا كنا ظالمين فما زالت تلك دعواهم حتى جعلناهم حصيدا خامدين
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you beautiful recitation. The beginning of Surah Al-Anbiya, the prophets of Allah. The first ayah and the relationship between how the surah starts and the prophets of Allah. That the reckoning for the people is coming very, very near to them. The day of judgment is drawing closer and closer while people are in ghafla, in forgetfulness, turning away from the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the message of the messengers. The prophets of Allah, they were sent by the truth. And people, instead of taking this message and holding fast to it, they turn away from it. And they are in a state of forgetfulness. They're playing. And this is the world that we live in today. People are just inventing ways for them to be even more forgetful. And playing and enjoying and having fun. And turning away from the message of the messengers. Turning away from the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the final messenger of Allah. And the Muslims, they ought to be the first not to be among those who are forgetful, not turning away from the way of the Prophet ﷺ, to turn their faces away, to face the ways of the disbelievers and their ways and their enjoyment and the like of this. And the hearts, if it's distracted from the truth, then there's nothing good in this life. And when people are in state of forgetfulness, they would look down at the message of the messengers and they would say they're just human beings and it's sorcery and the like of this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the beginning of the surah that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed nations before as a result of this. And He sent messengers, He sent men. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا قَبْلَكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent men. All the prophets of Allah, they were men. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to them. So as the people of knowledge, if you do not know, because the people of knowledge are the inheritors of the prophets. As the Prophet ﷺ said, الْعُلَمَاء وَرَثَةُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ The people of knowledge, the people of dhikr, they are the inheritors of the prophets. They inherited the knowledge of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this book, the Quran, and for people of reason to really reflect upon it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind the reciter of Surah Al-Anbiya of how many towns have been destroyed before and new generations have been brought to mankind. And every time a nation come, and the message is presented to them and they are in state of forgetfulness and turn away from it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. And it's too late for them when the punishment of Allah comes, it's too late for them when it comes to the repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's all lessons for the people to take heed and to take lesson from it, that people need to really hold fast to the message of the messengers and for us to really be proud of being Muslims and following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As the surah inshallah ta'ala will continue with great meanings and the mention of the prophets of Allah, but we'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more recitation from the surah by Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Please go ahead and continue. Okay. Inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وما خلقنا السماء والأرض وما بينهما لاعبين. لو أردنا أن نتخذ لهوا لاتخذناه من لدنا إن كنا فاعلين. بل نقذف بالحق على الباطل فيدمغه فإذا هو زاهق ولكم الويل مما تصفون. وله من في السماوات والأرض ومن عنده لا يستكبرون عن عبادته ولا يستحسرون. يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفترون. أم اتخذوا آلهة من الأرض هم ينشرون. لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا فسبحان الله رب العرش عما يصفون. لا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. أم اتخذوا من دونه آلهة قل هاتوا برهانكم هذا ذكر من معي وذكر من قبلي بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون الحق فهم معرضون. وما أرسلنا من قبلك من رسول إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. وقالوا اتخذ الرحمن ولدا سبحانه بل عباد مكرمون. لا يسبقونه بالقول وهم بأمره يعملون. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يشفعون إلا لمن ارتضى وهم من خشيته مشفقون. ومن يقل منهم إني إله من دونه فذلك نجزيه جهنم. ومن يقل منهم إني إله من دونه فذلك نجزيه جهنم كذلك نجزي الظالمين.
ما شاء الله, very nice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Verses really that should touch each and every one of us heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that the heavens and the earth are not created for play. People, the believers especially, they would never say such a thing. But sometimes our actions, as if the heavens and the earth is for play, for no reason. Our actions, our speech, our life has to be according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth for. He created them for us to worship Him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a very serious matter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. And people, when they turn away from the message of the messengers, as if with their actions they're saying that there is no purpose of one's life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything belongs to Him. And therefore those who arrogantly turn away from the worship of Allah, then they would never be successful. And that's why we need to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said that that whoever take a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the heavens and the earth would have not been in place if there was a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So nothing is to question, nobody is to question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is able to do all things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuted those who would say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took a son, and how evil that is. And as we see, it's repeated in the Quran from one surah to the other. They claim that the angels are the daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the like of this. The people of Jahiliyyah among the Arabs, they claim the same or the like of what the Christians said about Isa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the creation of Allah are the creation of Allah. And some of the characteristics of the angels that are in constant worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, none of them would ever dare to say that they are to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is false, this is deviation, this is man-made, invented matters of belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is away from all of this. So again, the verses is establishing the message of the messengers. And that's why it's Suratul Anbiya. All of the messengers of Allah, they came with one message and one message only, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more verses from Surah Al-Anbiya by Sheikh Kareem. Please go ahead and continue inshallah.
أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ أَفَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ وجعلنا في الأرض رواسي أن تميد بهم وجعلنا فيها فجاجا سبلا لعلهم يهتدون وجعلنا السماء سقفا محفوظا وهم عن آياتها معرضون وهو الذي خلق الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر كل في فلك يسبحون وما جعلنا لبشر من قبلك الخلد أفإن مت فهم الخالدون كل نفس ذائقة الموت كل نفس ذائقة الموت ونبلوكم بالشر والخير فتنة وإلينا ترجعون وإذا رآك الذين كفروا إن يتخذونك إلا هزوا أهذا الذي يذكر آلهتكم وهم بذكر الرحمن هم كافرون خلق الإنسان من عجل سأريكم آياتي فلا تستعجلون ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين لو يعلم الذين كفروا حين لا يكفون عن وجوههم النار ولا عن ظهورهم ولا هم ينصرون بل تأتيهم بغتة فتبهتهم فلا يستطيعون ردها ولا هم ينظرون ولقد استهزئ برسل من قبلك فحاق بالذين سخروا منهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون قل من يكلؤكم بالليل والنهار من الرحمن قل من يكلؤكم بالليل والنهار من الرحمن بل هم عن ذكر ربهم معرضون أم لهم آلهة تمنعهم من دوننا لا يستطيعون نصر أنفسهم ولا هم منا يصحبون بل متعنا هؤلاء وآباءهم حتى طال عليهم العمر أفلا يرون أنا نأتي الأرض ننقصها من أطرافها أفهم الغالبون
ما شاء الله may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you very nice recitation that should affect our hearts because the Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it has its right place and the Quran is the place where the Quran should work which is the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in these verses that the creation of the heavens and the earth is from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's always a reminder for the people, for the reciters of the Quran about the creation of Allah. The set of ayat and signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that should bring the heart to humble itself to the creator of the heavens and the earth and that everybody shall taste death and every soul will taste death and everyone is tested as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً the test is with evil and good the test is not just with evil with also good whatever is good is also a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whether we continue to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not and everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the message of the messengers but with more of the benefit that we learn from these verses and with more verses from Surah Al-Anbiya we'll do that and we'll continue with that inshallah ta'ala after the break so stay with us inshallah.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome back and with more verses from Surah Al-Anbiya. This blessed surah that talks about the message of the prophets of Allah and many of the prophets of Allah are mentioned in this surah. But it's important for us to get to know the message of all the prophets of Allah and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, not to be deceived by the ways of the disbelievers, the ways of forgetfulness and just enjoying this life without knowing the purpose in it and looking into the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He created the heavens and the earth and how the disbelievers, whenever they are deceived in this life, they think that there is no promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they would regret it in the Day of Judgment when they see the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unto them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sustainer of the heavens and the earth, and everybody should really humble themselves to the creator of the heavens and the earth. So we'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more verses of this blessed surah and more lessons for us to learn and to recite. And we'll start again with Sheikh Ahmad Rajab. So please go ahead and continue the recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل إنما أنذركم بالوحي ولا يسمع الصم الدعاء إذا ما ينذرون ولئن مستهم نفحة من عذاب ربك ليقولن يا ويلنا إنا كنا ظالمين ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة فلا تظلم نفس شيئا وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل أتينا بها وكفى بنا حاسبين ولقد آتينا موسى وهارون الفرقان وضياء وذكرا للمتقين الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب وهم من الساعة مشفقون وهذا ذكر مبارك أنزلناه أفأنتم له منكرون ولقد آتينا إبراهيم رشده من قبل وكنا به عالمين إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما هذه التماثيل التي أنتم لها عاكفون قالوا وجدنا آباءنا لها عابدين قال لقد كنتم أنتم وآباؤكم في ضلال مبين قالوا أجئتنا بالحق أم أنت من اللاعبين قال بل ربكم رب السماوات والأرض الذي فطرهن وأنا على ذلكم من الشاهدين وتالله لأكيدن أصنامكم بعد أن تولوا مدبرين فجعلهم جذاذا إلا كبيرا لهم لعلهم إليه يرجعون قالوا من فعل هذا بآلهتنا إنه لمن الظالمين قالوا سمعنا فتى يذكرهم يقال له إبراهيم قالوا فأتوا به على أعين الناس لعلهم يشهدون قالوا أأنت فعلت هذا بآلهتنا يا إبراهيم قال بل فعله كبيرهم هذا فاسألوهم إن كانوا ينطقون فرجعوا إلى فقالوا إنكم أنتم الظالمون ثم نكسوا على رؤوسهم لقد علمت ما هؤلاء ينطقون قال أفتعبدون من دون الله ما لا ينفعكم شيئا ولا يضركم أف لكم ولما تعبدون من دون الله أفلا تعقلون قالوا حرقوه وانصروا آلهتكم إن كنتم فاعلين قلنا يا نار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم وأرادوا به كيدا فجعلناهم الأخسرين ونجيناه ولوطا إلى الأرض التي باركنا فيها للعالمين ووهبنا له إسحاق ويعقوب نافلة وكلا جعلنا صالحين وجعلناهم أئمة يهدون بأمرنا وأوحينا إليهم فعل الخيرات وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وكانوا لنا عابدين
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Beautiful recitation, Surah Al-Anbiya, and the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him one of the Ulil Azm min al-Rusul, one of the mighty messengers of Allah, those who faced many trials and tests. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided Ibrahim alayhi salam with the strong hujjah and evidence to bring the truth to the people. One of the miseries of the human beings, as it's mentioned in that story, is that they refer to the truth, that this is something that they found their parents and their forefathers doing. And that's nothing, basically. There's nothing to prove that this is right, just for the fact that their forefathers were doing something. This is what the people of Ibrahim alayhi salam, they said when he questioned their belief, their faith. He said, what is these idols that you are worshipping and you would spend the time worshipping them and so on and so forth? They said, قَالُوا وَجَدَنَا أَبَاءَنَا لَهَا عَبِدِينَ. We found our forefathers worshipping it. Is that sufficient for a person to do something? And this is when you really reflect upon it. Most of the human beings are like this. They just follow the religions of their forefathers. And that's why even as one of the scholars like Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, the weakest level of Iman is the faith of the ways of the forefathers. Even if it's on the truth, a person has to establish al-Iman with clear evidence and looking into the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, when the people said that to him and he invited them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and destroyed the idols that they used to worship, to make it clear to them that these idols cannot bring benefit to themselves, let alone to push away harm. And when they tried to punish Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created the fire, he's the one subhanahu wa ta'ala that ordered the fire to be cool and to be safe for Ibrahim alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees something, nothing would ever stand against the power and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the mention of Ishaq and Ya'qub and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided them. And this was a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he made them leaders in which they would guide, and people are guided by them. And he inspired them to do what is good and to establish the salah and to give the zakah. And they were worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, example for mankind. And also clear example of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give victory to the believers, to the prophets of Allah, and those who follow the prophets of Allah, as long as they are steadfast, conveying the truth, and they don't fear anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us this in the Quran. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more of the prophets of Allah mentioned in the surah. And Sheikh Abdul Rahman, please continue with the recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولوطا آتيناه حكما وعلما ونجيناه من القرية التي كانت تعمل الخبائث إنهم كانوا قوم سوء فاسقين وأدخلناه في رحمتنا من الصالحين ونوحا إذ نادى من قبل فاستجبنا له فنجيناه وأهله من الكرب العظيم ونصرناه من القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا إنهم كانوا قوم سوء فأغرقناهم أجمعين وداود وسليمان إذ يحكمان في الحرث إذ نفشت فيه غنم القوم وكنا لحكمهم شاهدين ففهمناها سليمان وكلا آتينا حكما وعلما وسخرنا مع داود الجبال يسبحن والطير وكنا فاعلين وعلمناه صنعة لبوس لكم لتحصنكم من بأسكم فهل أنتم شاكرون ولسليمان الريح عاصفة تجري بأمره إلى الأرض التي باركنا فيها وكنا بكل شيء عالمين ومن الشياطين من يغوصون له ويعملون عملا دون ذلك وكنا لهم حافظين وأيوب إذ نادى ربه أني مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين فاستجبنا له فكشفنا ما به من ضر وآتيناه أهله ومثلهم معهم رحمة من عندنا وذكرى للعابدين وإسماعيل وإدريس وذا الكفل كل من الصابرين وأدخلناهم في رحمتنا إنهم من الصالحين وذا النون إذ ذهب مغاضبا فظن أن لن نقدر عليه فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين وزكريا إذ نادى ربه رب لا تذرني فردا وأنت خير الوارثين فاستجبنا له ووهبنا له يحيى وأصلحنا له زوجه إنهم كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات ويدعوننا رغبا ورهبا وكانوا لنا خاشعين والتي أحصنت فرجها فنفخنا فيها من روحنا فنفخنا فيها من روحنا وجعلناها وابنها آية للعالمين.
ما شاء الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. There's nothing better to mention the prophets of Allah, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for them to convey the message of the truth. They are the best of all the human beings, and that's why it's blessings to mention their name, and especially if it's the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. We heard about Ibrahim alayhi salam and Lut alayhi salam, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the knowledge and the authority, and He saved them from those people, those the evil doers, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Nuh alayhi salam to convey His message, and He also saved him from his people, and He caused his people to drown, as we know, and Dawood and Sulaiman and the rest of the prophets of Allah, as it's mentioned in these verses. And all of them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed His mercy upon them. And one of the prophets of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him, the Noon, and how this is something also to be true for the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, and as it's mentioned in the verse, that when he was in the inside of the whale, or underneath the ocean, and he said, "La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin," and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, "Wa kadhalika nunji al-mu'minin." This is also how the believers will be saved, if they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and how that the kalimatu tawheed, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and humbling oneself, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the humbleness comes when a person understands and recognizes that he is among the wrongdoers. That affects the heart with humbleness after the mention that no one is worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each prophet is mentioned with a virtue. And this virtue mentioned in these verses is important for us to try to have it in our life. So for example, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about Zakariya alayhi salam, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he bestowed on him a righteous wife. Why? Because they used to be in haste in doing good, and they would call, invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with hoping for the rewards from Allah, and out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they humbled themselves and they had the fear of Allah. Therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made his wife righteous for him. And also the mention of Maryam and the son of Maryam. And then it comes after that, that the purpose of all of this, that this is nothing but one ummah. All the prophets of Allah, they are sent with one message, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. There's no religions as people try to convey. It's only one religion, which is the religion of Islam. All the prophets of Allah, they came with that one religion, to submit oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Yes, the shara'i' was different, the rulings and the halal and the haram, but the message is the same, worshipping the creator of the heavens and the earth alone, and all of them till the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no messenger to come after him, and everybody should follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's what we would hear also towards the end of the surah. And Shaykh Kareem inshallah ta'ala would recite to us till the end of Surah Al-Anbiya. So let's listen inshallah ta'ala to the recitation. Go ahead inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Inna hadhihi ummatukum ummatan wahidatan wa ana rabbukum fa'budun. وتقطعوا أمرهم بينهم كل إلينا راجعون فمن يعمل من الصالحات وهو مؤمن فلا كفران لسعيه وإنا له كاتبون وحرام على قرية أهلكناها أنهم لا يرجعون حتى إذا فتحت يأجوج ومأجوج وهم من كل حدب ينسلون واقترب الوعد الحق فإذا هي شاخصة أبصار الذين كفروا يا ويلنا قد كنا في غفلة من هذا فإذا هي شاخصة أبصار الذين كفروا يا ويلنا قد كنا في غفلة من هذا بل كنا ظالمين إنكم وما تعبدون من دون الله حصب جهنم أنتم لها واردون لو كان هؤلاء آلهة ما وردوها وكل فيها خالدون لهم فيها زفير وهم فيها لا يسمعون إن الذين سبقت لهم منا الحسنى أولئك عنها مبعدون لا يسمعون حسيسها وهم فيما اشتهت أنفسهم خالدون لا يحزنهم الفزع الأكبر وتتلقاهم الملائكة هذا يومكم الذي كنتم توعدون يوم نطوي السماء كطي السجل للكتب كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده وعدا علينا إنا كنا فاعلين ولقد كتبنا في الزبور من بعد الذكر أن الأرض يرثها عبادي الصالحون إن في هذا لبلاغا لقوم عابدين وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين قل إنما يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فهل أنتم مسلمون فإن تولوا فقل آذنتكم على سواء وإن أدري أقريب أم بعيد ما توعدون إنه يعلم الجهر من القول ويعلم ما تكتمون وإن أدري لعله فتنة لكم ومتاع إلى حين قال رب احكم بالحق وربنا الرحمن المستعان على ما تصفون
MashaAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this nice recitation. And that's the end of Surah Al-Anbiya and the message in the Surah after mentioning all the prophets of Allah. As we said, the religion was one religion, and that is the religion of Al-Islam. this beautiful way of life, and that is to submit oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to worship Him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala, as it's mentioned, قُلْ إِنَّمَا يُوحَى إِلَيْ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to say, that was revealed to me is that your Lord, the one to be worshipped, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So are you Muslims? The same way of all the messengers before. And just before that, because the end and the final messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, he is being sent as a mercy to mankind. Every messenger, as we heard the messengers of Allah, if people turn away from their message, they get destroyed. This messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the final messenger. Allah sent him as a mercy to mankind for them to follow him. Great benefits that we really can reflect upon, but because of the time, we have to end the program. But we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this can inspire ourselves and the viewers to explore the ayat of Allah, to increase with the recitation and the reflection and acting according to the book of Allah. This is the book of guidance. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deeds and to bless our lives with the book of Allah. Wa sallallahu sallam wa barak ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
قل لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله أنزلناه وبالحق نزل وما أرسلناك إلا مبشرا ونذيرا.